Cyborg Alpha, Infinite Tween and Middle School for Life, produced in association with akadhmia.university TV, a project of akadhmia.university, open and free education and knowledge. akadhmia.university TV and Kawaii Tea House TV are a part of Cyborg Alpha TV Network. Experimental TV.
Well, it's 16 hours and 42 minutes into the 23rd day of December 2021. We have a package to open. So we're beginning our day with a package opening. I don't really know what it is. I have some idea what it might be. But beyond that, anybody's guessing. So, wrong way. Here's the package I'm opening. Got my scissors. Before, I'd have the package already opened, but didn't do that. So let's get on to a little bit of a conversation here while we're doing the package opening. The notes are coming along. Notes will end up producing from memoirs and other such items that you find in these archives. Proved to be quite interesting. Like, this is what I'm working on, is to understand slavery, the origins of slavery, globally speaking. I went into not the, here it is, okay. It's the new tablet's in. Yay for that. I'm going to charge it up. I didn't look at standard history. What I did is I went into the memoirs of the Dutch trading companies. And this is particularly the Dutch East India Company. And as I went through their archives, I found a lot of interesting things. Things I didn't really know before. And there's a lot more to history than we initially thought. So here it is here. This is the tablet. I have to charge it up, so that's what I'm going to do. And I will see you later on in the evening for when I get back for tonight's little bit of session. I'll talk more about the notes that I've found and how I'm reorganizing my notes now. I'm in that period now, so there's not much of an observation vlog. That's going to be coming up soon. Anyways, we'll talk more tonight. Well, it's officially Christmas Eve, even though it's 5 hours and 15 minutes into the 24th day of December, 2021. Yeah, so 5 o'clock in the morning, it's still Christmas Eve. Well, this is when Christmas Eve begins. And anyways, we're here doing... I had forgotten to do the transitions later on, earlier on. I was in the process, and I'll show you, that I've got a new tablet here. We're adding and upgrading our research desk. So we've got our nice little tablet here. So this is what it looks like. Very quick, very fast. So it will certainly add to the desktop. The research capacity will increase, and that means more notes, more research, and so on and so forth. So we are moving towards February 1st, going back into the deep dive. It's not that we stopped doing the work. We still are taking notes. This is the thing. The note-taking continues. It really depends on the environment that's around as to whether or not we continue on with the research. If enough information can be found, the right information can be found, then you go ahead, you move ahead with the research, with taking the notes. And this is how everything is kind of, how it's scheduled in. It's basically, let me get my thoughts together. There were several thoughts and ideas that sort of collided together. vacation doesn't necessarily mean time off when you enjoy the stuff you're doing. I like puzzles, I like scavenger hunts, and I like gaming. I'm a gamer, but I'm a nerd gamer. And for me, the nerd gaming, and this is the whole key to nerd gaming, is the challenge. So it's not about being the best, it's not about being, oh, number one and always at the top and whatever. It's about the challenge. You have to have the challenge there. And in this case here, the challenge, if the challenge arises and the time for gameplay is there, in other words, the information that you need to find, because this is nerd gaming, it's all about studying. If the information that is there and you can pick it up, you can then you continue forward with the game. Vacation is more along the lines of, I'm sleeping in more. I'm sleeping longer hours. That's the vacation. It's not that it's shorter, you know, in terms of doing nothing all day long. It just means that, let me adjust the camera here. It just means that I am not spending all day long. I'm not necessarily pushing myself to the absolute limit because I am taking extra hours to sleep. I'm sleeping in longer. Other challenges do pop in, other issues pop in, that sort of in some ways reduces the amount of sleep that I'm getting, because I do have to do another contract on the 25th. Tomorrow, that's the Saturday the 25th. What's happening on the 25th is we're having St. Spiridon's. I'm finishing up the test bench work on the mixer. That's going to replace the old mixer that broke. And I'll do the replacement on Saturday after church. So, but typically, if I'm going to church in the morning, and church doesn't end, the full thing doesn't end until 3 o'clock in the afternoon, that means I'm not sleeping. So I will end up losing another day of sleep over the weekend, and that's gonna knock me out again, and I'll be out for a couple of days before I recover from the weekend adventure. So. But that's neither here nor there. We're moving on to, we finished the YouTube stroll, and we're going on now to Kim Possible. And this is my cartoon section of the nighttime routine, if you will. Well, from the looks of it, you know what this is. This is the beginning of the day, but it's also a package opening. So it's 19 hours and 45 minutes into the 24th day of December 2021. Merry Christmas to everyone who is celebrating tonight and tomorrow. There will be another celebration for Christmas, the second Christmas. On January 6th and January 7th, those are particularly people, the Christians from the Eastern tradition. The Eastern tradition is on the 6th and 7th. This includes the Russians and Ukrainians, as well as many people within the Middle East. The Western celebration is on the 25th, and that's due to a shift in the calendar. Ironically enough, the shift in the calendar didn't occur, so let's open this package up. I know what this is. Didn't occur until the late 1800s in the United States, so a large chunk of the election calendar that goes on with the elections is done under the Eastern calendar, if you will. So George Washington would have celebrated Christmas on what we now know as the 6th and 7th. Back then, the 6th and 7th was the 24th and the 25th of December, but it shifted. We shifted from a astronomical calendar to a solar calendar. On the solar calendar, the 24th and 25th are around the solstice, but Christmas moves up to January 6th and January 7th because of the shift in dates between the solar and astronomical calendar. So that's your explanation for that. And anyways, was waiting for. It came in a little earlier than expected. It's the mixer. So that's in. I still do have to place one more order, but that's not going to be for another year or so. So, anyways, at the Yowie Vlogs, they're still currently in Hawaii, so we'll see what ends up happening now. All right, so we'll see you in a bit.
Akadhmia University. Go beyond standard knowledge.
Well, just found out that people, well, not really, knew this a while. People have no common sense. And I think it doesn't matter what you tell them, there's always this doubt that, oh, you might be wrong. And so they are stuck in a quandary because they don't know what to do. And they know little to nothing. Their depth of knowledge is basically that of Oprah, and that's about as far as it goes. This includes some of these people who pretend to be intellectuals. And there's one guy, you know, on RT named Tom something or other. Can't remember what his last name is. And his whole thing with everything that's going on is that, oh, these are conspiracy theorists, these are idiots, and he brings up these almost ridiculous arguments that don't even apply. So it's not observation-based, it's not evidence-based in terms of what he's presenting. It's simply his opinion. And his opinion is, again, because this is the way intellectuals are, the way Lionel is. Everyone's been seeing, you know, who's watched my stuff and has watched Lionel knows how Lionel behaves. Why? Because he's an intellectual. It's his thoughts, his ideas. They are the most spectacular. And this is why you should pay to go behind that, you know, pay for his subscription and see how wonderful he is. And of course, now he's sort of changed the tune a little bit and he says, well, okay, I guess that's because not enough people followed. And so, you know, he goes out and says, well, you know, it's one thing to preach to the choir, it's one another thing to go out there and sort of change people's minds, to educate people. And that's true. But the thing is, this is why I said, you know, forget the paywall. If people aren't going to, if you're not going to be able to find a platform to publish what you want to publish, and the thing is, there's always different ways of doing it. Historically, even without the internet, there's always been ways. So what happens is you just simply find ways. If you, let's say, go down a path where you're using something that's very small or, you know, not sufficiently large, well, then you work to grow the platform. That's just, you know, this is how small papers work. You know how many underground papers, how many underground chat clubs there are? There's thousands of them. Everybody has an idea. Everyone has thoughts and ideas. Everyone's a writer. Everyone's a journalist. Everyone does investigation. Everyone's a researcher. And you have all these people coming out with these degrees and these sort of so-called education who are intellectuals who want to show how great they are. And they want to do their writing. They want to, you know, show how wonderful they write. And, you know, you got to listen to me because I am this and I am that. And that's as far as it goes. They don't, it's their own bravado, it's their own sense of thought, their own sense of ideas. Of course, there are other people who have no thoughts or ideas of their own, and they simply glom onto things. These are the people who, well, basically, they're the sheeple. They have no thoughts and ideas of their own. They follow trends. They're trend followers. And we know that the majority of the people are trend followers. You follow one trend or another. You see these people, you know, go from one trend to another trend to another trend, and you just see the amount of money they spend on these trends. Unbelievable. People will go out and buy, being convinced that you needed to freeze your food in order to stock up for emergency needs. I know people who have two freezers filled with crap, but they got these subscription boxes. They didn't label anything they put in. Can't remember what they put in the freezer. And so I have to go to food shop even further because they can't remember what's in the freezer. Two freezers filled, I've seen. I mean, how often are you going to use everything that you have in there? And after a while, in the freezer, things go bad. That's called freezer burn. And the thing is, they don't understand that. This is not part of their vocabulary, not part of their mindset. It may be part of their vocabulary, but it's not part of their mindset. It's not they may, I know the word, but this is not something to think about when they have two freezers filled with, well, basically food, and they can't find enough to eat. They say, oh, there's not, and they have to go out in the food shop because there's nothing to eat in the house. But the thing is they'll go from club to club to club to subscription to subscription to subscription just because it's a fad. Everyone else is doing it, and I'm going to do the same thing. You know, that's it. No people who have two freezers filled with food. And then as soon as the fad comes along, they have the one now where you can for a subscription price, food, a meal sent to you, where they give you the recipe, all the ingredients are measured out, and you can make the food right out of there. Oh, look, we're going to have fresh food. But what about all the stuff in your freezer? Doesn't matter, because everybody else is doing it, so we're going to do the same thing. So they're going to the subscription, another subscription, two freezers filled with food, but now they have a meal subscription plan that sends them their meals, uncooked, but with the recipe, and the ingredients pre-measured out, and there you go. I can guarantee you that a large chunk of that stuff is going to go into the freezer, or more likely not, into the garbage, 3-4 months down the road. But they'll still be on the hook for a year's worth of a year-long subscription. They don't pay attention to what they're getting in terms of their services, for internet, phone, or whatever. They allow themselves to be talked into deals and into, oh, you're going to have this wonderful thing here. They don't. And 6 months down the road, because they didn't read the frying pan, they didn't check things properly. That was only a 6-month offer. Your prices are now tripling. Again, didn't see, and so they're back on the phone again every 6 to 8 months, screaming at the customer service, at whatever cable company or phone company you want to be with, that they're being ripped off. And it's because they simply just didn't pay attention to what the details were. So every 6 to 8 months, they get to work themselves up. They, work themselves into a lather, and they get on the phone, and they start screaming and yelling. And this is what we see on Twitter. What are we seeing on Twitter? We're seeing this exact same thing. People yelling and screaming for no particular reason. Then you have these other people who think they're intellectuals, will sit back and they'll give you an argument, and most people won't even test the argument out to see whether or not what they're talking about is even to any degree of reasonable. And this is the hard part now. We're talking about reasonable. There is no reason anymore. If there's no reason, there is no reasonable. And this is kind of the nature of things. Anyway, I've been doing my editing. I've got more vlogs ready to go up. And I've got this, I said I was going to show it. It's the, it's the type of mixture that I have, like this, very tiny, very small. This is what I have to record outside. I have two microphones hooked up here, and using the microphones hooked up to the device. I have one microphone right now, but I could add a second one. I get a good live sound. This is how I've improved the sound quality for my devices. So, I'm happy with it. It didn't cost me much. This is the most expensive one. This is going to go to my music channel. to my music studio. I gotta figure out how to turn this off. For some reason, it's not turning off. Anyways, I'll leave it the way it is now. It'll eventually turn off on its own. And then the smaller ones, the cheaper ones, will do just as good a job. The one I use particularly, I spent $25 on. It does a great job. They've got a lot of features on. This has more features, but as I said, I'm supposed to be turning it off now, and it's not turning off, so I'll wait for itself to turn off and go through the sort of the auto-off function and go from there. Anyways, it's been about 10 minutes. I'm on to my YouTube stroll. It is the new Christmas, so Merry Christmas for those who are celebrating on the 25th. We're officially into Boxing Day now. I did the work at church that I needed to get done. But again, that was a pulling on all-nighter, so by the time I got back around 6 o'clock, I just ended up going to bed. So I'm just getting up now for a pit stop and something to eat and do the YouTube stroll.
We are Cyborg Alpha, infinite tween and middle school for life, produced in association with Akadhmia University TV, a project of Akadhmia University. Open and free education and knowledge. Akadhmia University TV and YET House TV are a part of Cyborg Alpha TV Network. Experimental TV.